Representative Lee Terry's in studio with us. How you doing, sir?
Hi. Hey,
great. How are you all this morning?
With the Husker fight song playing underneath us, I have to ask you, is one of the perks of being a member of House of Representatives, you just get to walk into Memorial Stadium, walk down on the field, you get to just stand by the coaches? Do you just have pretty much run of the stadium?
No on every one of them.
No? Have you tried? Yes, have you tried to do that?
I would. No.
Oh, man.
I'll do it.
But I have my own season tickets that I've had before
you do?
I was elected.
Okay.
So I'm good there.
Okay.
Now, I do every once in a while, but I haven't done it in 2 years, is call down and say, can I show up to a practice? And they say, sure.
That's cool.
That's very
cool. So I get that.
Yeah.
That's a perk.
And that is cool.
Because I'm going to tell you right now, Pat couldn't do that.
No.
Oh, I bet he could.
If I called my friend,
he could talk his way in. I am really confident
of
that.
Wait, Pat, is this Pat the...
No. I did have a beer with the governor in his living room a couple of years ago. So that's cooler than any
that,
practice.
You drop that, they'll let you right in.
You think
the stadium,
so? Yes. Yeah, I bet. I bet they will.
I think the governor's there every day for practice.
Is he?
That's a perk of being
he
the
loves
governor.
Attending the practices.
I would be. I mean, if I was
they
the governor.
They even let him talk to the team, so I can't do that.
No offense to the governor, but he's not the best motivational speaker, I wouldn't think, before like the game. I think you need... You know what I'm saying?
I mean, I know
he's
what a good, you're talking about.
He's just not. I love the guy. He's a great guy, and he's a great governor. But
well, that's
not,
the West Point. He just wants him to stand at attention, and that's not very motivational.
That's not fun.
It is so not fun.
Doesn't get you pumped.
Yeah, it just.
Yeah, well, that would be pretty cool.
Well, thanks for getting up so early and coming in and hanging out with us for a little bit. We appreciate it.
Well, I've got kids that are already at school, so I'm always up.
Oh,
so
you're there
up
and ready to go. That's true.
Time, yeah.
That is true. That's it. Yeah, Pat finally, he's got all the kids in school, so he and his wife have the day off now, finally.
To hang out, catch up on our True Blood. Yeah.
We won't ask about afternoons.
No. Well, trust me, there's not much to ask about.
It's a good nap.
It's a great nap. Great nap time. That couch.
That's all I've heard about so far.
Yeah. Well, that's all we've done.
I can relate to that.
Are you going to be in Lincoln on Saturday?
Absolutely.
Are you excited about it?
Yeah, I really
am.
Going
to the Big Ten?
Oh, I'm pumped.
I'm very excited about this.
Yeah, I've really have a hard time with the Texas Conference. So when we got
the
out
Texas
of that,
conference.
I was one of those that really supported.
Yeah. Like, you want your own conference? Here, you can have it all to yourself.
Go ahead,
Yeah, you can have it. We're out.
So what's on your mind now? I mean, you guys are still on break. How long are you on break for?
Until next week, right after Labor Day, head back. And I spent this August break visiting with as many businesses as possible and hearing their stories. And it's a varied story. I mean, we have a couple of retailers that are pretty optimistic. We have some small businesses that carpet cleaning and type of things that are a verge of shutting their doors. So it's the full spectrum in the Omaha area. We blessed with a low unemployment rate, but small businesses are really getting hammered
kind
even here.
Just struggling a little bit. That's true. Yeah, sometimes, as they say, what happens on the coast, we don't sometimes feel it as intensely or as soon.
Right.
You know, it might take a while for it to get here eventually, and sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes it doesn't. Everything's a little bit more leveled off here. It's not as extreme.
Yeah.
But it is.
But everybody's worried, so that's the one common denominator of every business, even our Fortune 500. Everybody's concerned about the future.
Well, they
want to
know where the
path's
going to go. Which way is it going to go, and for how long?
And
you know,
nobody knows
exactly. Yeah, they just want some assurances, because it's kind of like you don't want that short term fix, because like, well, that's nothing to put all your eggs in one basket on and say, okay, well, I'm going to go with it because they promised for 6 months we're going to do this, and you know, most people are saying, well, we'll just wait 6 months and see what happens next, and understandably, because that's their family's fortune and. You know, and everything that they've built their whole lifetime, they don't want to gamble it.
Absolutely. And that's even the businesses that are making money are very timid about hiring. So they're what cash they may be making, they're saving.
Right,
because
Because
they don't know what their expenses are going to be or what the economy is going to be. So it's hard to create jobs. And that's the ultimate question is, how do we create jobs, even in the Omaha metropolitan area?
Yeah, that's true. If there's no money to put out there, nobody wants to hire somebody, which is understandable, because you can do that in your own household. If things are looking a little bit shaky up ahead, you tend to sock it away. Like, well, let's just wait. We don't need to buy the new washer and dryer yet. Mm-hmm. We can save that money.
That's exactly right.
Because we'll just wait and see kind of how things go, and we'll make do until we can. And I think that's where people get frustrated, because they feel like, you know, sometimes when you're looking on the big picture as far as the federal scene, you just see the checks being written to do things, and sometimes they're just like, where are we going to get that money?
Right.
You know, and for us, you know, and a household, you don't get to do that.
You don't really just get to deficit spend and then print more money.
Let's just go get
That'd
another
equity.
That'd
be great if we could.
Yeah. Well, it would be illegal for you.
but not
for the federal government. By the way, my wife wanted me to thank you guys for playing Maroon 5 a couple minutes ago. That's her favorite band.
Absolutely.
Oh, that's cool.
She was going to make me drive her to Des Moines when they played there for their state fair.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
But we didn't.
Oh, now you owe her.
See, now I do owe her.
You owe her. You're going to have to do that.
Yeah. So she, about a week ago, wanted me to look up their tour schedule, and she said, see if they're in Vegas. Maybe we could go see them in Vegas.
It's like, maybe you can't get us in to see the Huskers. Can you get us in to see Maroon 5?
Well, that would be easier.
Pull some strings. You know,
it
would be.
On their schedule, are they going to come through Omaha? Did you see, or anywhere?
I did not see them on Omaha's schedule.
At all?
At all. And neither was Smashing Pumpkins.
Oh,
I
dear
looked
Lord.
Them up too.
Not the last thing I expected.
That was
to hear
my
you
band.
Say.
She's Maroon 5.
That's the
5.
Last thing I expected to hear you say.
I seriously, I cannot imagine you seeing you front row Smashing Pumpkins. That is not what I did not pick up.
See, learn something new, Pat.
They're at a club in D.C., but it's when I'm back here. So timing is everything.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yes.
Well, if Maroon 5 ever comes through town, tell your wife that we'll hook her up.
All right.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah. And we'll make,
I can't, so we'll, you we'll, come through. So
there goes Pat. Overpromise and underdeliver. Here we go. Overpromise and underdeliver. Here we go again.
Story of my life.
Great.
So Schick and Nick, they're our sports directors from our sister station. They're going to come in here in a few minutes, and we're going to chat Husker football. So we want you to chime in on this one. We're going to have them in for just a couple minutes, talk a little Husker football and anything else going on in sports.
All nutted up at 2 apiece here.
You didn't have a horse in the fight.
Hey. It's Schick and Nick from 1620 Design.
Oh, it helps to be well-spoken.
And what's up, boys?
Nothing, man.
How's it going?
It's
Representative
feeling good.
V. Terry's in here, too, and
it's
we're all talking Husker football.
I'm the only one in a suit. That's the weird thing.
Yeah, you're the only one in a suit. Yeah. Representative Terry has his crate
and
jacket.
Come in and visit with a Shields Sports. Expert about the Yeah. Who would have thought?
I mean, I got to give him credit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I take Terry would be here. Underdressed.
Yeah, really.
Of the three of us.
I mean, never expected this.
A tank top, really?
Yeah.
It's okay.
I'm the only one in a suit.
I know. If you're watching.
Terry's the only one with a beard. I mean, it's just not good.
You can see all this right now on our website, actually. Yeah.
Yeah, Q985FM.com, even though, like everybody,
We've
you guys,
you,
your
on.
Website is up and going, but Q's website's still a flash page.
Yeah, we're up and going.
Yeah, how's that working? Good?
Oh, it's going great.
Good.
Must be nice.
Yeah. It's been a rough month.
It's been a rough month.
We had a splash page for too long.
Yeah.
Really?
It was terrible.
It's a not make a splash page because it just
your splash only lasts for so long.
Yeah.
Well,
not very exciting.
We've all done a can opener.
No.
In any case. So anything new about this weekend?
No, just I haven't shaved in like 3 or 4 days. And
I'm not,
I don't care.
The light
about
hit
that.
You just right.
You can tell. You haven't shaved in
Pat?
4 days.
I'm just lazy right now. Kelly said last night that you could not shave for 3 weeks and you wouldn't have anything.
You wouldn't have anything.
So it's good to have internal support.
You have. It looks
the beard knows that. The beard knows if it's a supporter.
Yeah.
That seriously is 4 days worth of growth?
Three.
That is unreal.
Three.
That is 3 days.
What?
Ba and I don't shave for 20 minutes and we have a 5 o'clock shadow.
Santa in about 20.
Seriously.
He doesn't shave for 4 days and he looks like a junior in high school. Come on.
You gotta start somewhere.
So is the spread still, what, 35? 35 and a half?
I don't
know
if it's moved. I've
not checked.
Yeah. What are you feeling?
Aren't
are you feeling
excited about this or what? Stay on top of it.
I think they'll cover that, but. You know, it is just a lot of question marks.
We talked to a guy from a website called PredictionMachine.com, and they plug in a whole bunch of numbers.
It's a machine that makes
It's a machine that, it's yeah, it's like an oven, you know? You just put it in there. And they simulated these games, what, 50,000 times? Mm-hmm. 50,000 times.
and Nebraska beats Chattanooga 99.9% of the time.
And they beat them
47-10.
No,
it wasn't 100%.
The bus broke down. Going
yeah,
down.
Right.
Yeah. The 0.1% was when Chattanooga's bus broke down on the way to. They factor in everything. Mechanical failures of buses and everything.
All that stuff. Okay. 31-6 was the score. The machine spit out.
I'd seen where they talked to Taylor Martinez, though. Was it yesterday?
It felt awesome.
It feels like he's got a handle on the offense.
Which is good.
I would hope so.
I'm glad to hear that because we're 3 days away.
Yeah. So. Is he talking better this year? Taylor Martinez, like, is he more confident in front of the microphone? Or is he going to give us more gems like...
I got chills throughout my body.
Look, I will say this about Taylor Martinez, is that he is putting himself... trying to put himself out there. He's presenting himself better. Some guys have the gift of gab and some don't. Some do.
Awesome.
And some don't.
Right. That's right.
He's pointing to himself and to Vaughn. That's awesome.
It's good for radio when I just point to
people.
That's
great. Don't tell anybody. Yeah.
But I give him credit for getting out there and just saying, you know, trying his best to do it. He's not going to ever be what you want him to be in that regard. Never.
Well,
he
can learn. He just needs to get a little life coach. Teach him how to do that stuff, you know, dealing with the press.
A life coach.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
People
send
have
Nelson
to learn
down
how to
there?
Do that.
Should we send Nelson down?
We can have Nelson.
Life coach.
Nelson could coach him.
Were you guys, were you here when he welcomed Bo Pelini on his first day? I don't think you guys were on the air yet.
No.
The Friday before the first Husker game with Bo Pelini as head coach, it was the Husker breakfast.
Yeah.
And coach
the
was talking.
Big Red Breakfast.
Big Red Breakfast, thank you.
Whatever.
And after the breakfast, he went out for a jog around the
coach did that.
Nelson?
You know, yeah, coach
no,
did that.
Yeah, the
Nelson
coach
went
did.
For a jog?
No, no.
After some
Nelson
pancakes?
Nelson just chased
it's
him.
Amazing.
Nelson just chased
He's
him in the station vehicle.
There you go.
Yeah.
Nelson put overalls on and literally
and no
tailed
shirt.
Him through the streets and screamed, "Coach, coach!" Until finally he stopped his jog to get a picture with Nelson. He didn't smile, not even. He
Where's
was
the
so
picture?
It's on our computer. I'll find it for you. He looks so angry.
Why would you do that to him?
But I got
I don't think he's been the same ever since. He's been mean.
He wouldn't even shake my hand. And he's not playing it up. When we found him, he had just left the Big Red Breakfast. Like, you know when you're about to work out and you get in that mindset, like, it's time to go.
I hear you, dog.
He had that.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
He had the ramp up face on, like, okay, I'm about to start this jog. Then our old...
Is he doing before he runs out of the tunnel? Yep.
He still had, do you have the dress sock ring halfway up your calf? He still had the dress sock ring halfway up his calf.
So our old crummy door falling off the station vehicle comes screeching in like the A-team van. Two guys with cameras jump out yelling like it's a kidnapping scene. And then me, heavier than I am now, if that's possible, in only the overalls.
No shirt underneath.
No shirt, sweating.
I can't imagine why he wouldn't be thrilled.
You know what's more funny to me? That same day, they had me, Pat and JT, at 72nd and Dodge celebrating the first day, right? Giving out donuts from a box. And the only people that would take donuts for me were giving them to their kids.
Yeah, isn't that great?
So I didn't have anything on that said Q98.5 on Nelson.
So
I'm a radio DJ guy.
It sounds like Bo and you were both scarred that day.
Yes.
Interesting.
Yeah, that's probably true.
We'll show you that picture. It was great.
And this is, he wouldn't talk to him. This was before Nelson had braces.
Yeah.
And he wouldn't talk to him.
I don't remember pre-braces Nelson.
You don't?
I can't. I mean, obviously,
This is when he was really gangly.
Yeah.
Awkward. Awkward. That's in his awkward face.
This is when he was really tough to look at.
That's what it was. His awkward face.
Well, thanks, boys. Representative Lee Terry is in studio with us for a little bit. Again, thanks for coming in.
Hey, thanks for having me. This is awesome.
Absolutely. Yeah, we love having you come in. And glad you got to be here for the boys.
Oh, yeah. The guys are great.
Get to talk a little bit about football, talking about the weekend coming up.
Mm-hmm.
Very excited about that and Nelson's encounter with coach, which is why we can't go to practices.
Yeah.
That's the reason.
You asked why
I
we
understand.
Can't.
Yeah.
No,
we can't. So when you're heading back to Washington next week.
Next week.
Right after Labor
Day. I'll be there this time next week.
Now, how often do you go back and forth every week? Come
every
back to your
week.
Office?
My family lives here, so last vote, first flight.
Really?
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow. That's got to be a lot of miles, man. I mean, a lot of flights, you know, going back and forth.
It works out perfectly. It's about two hours, 15 out, two and a half back.
Yeah. That's not bad.
You know, it works out because I rack up enough miles to fly my family out once a year.
Oh, that's perfect.
So
that
does
is nice.
Work out.
That'd be kind of nice, though. Yeah, that would be all right.
Now, how often do people, like just regular Nebraskans...
stop by and say hi?
Yeah, like knock on your office door in Washington, or they call in advance, hey, can we come see your office? Does that ever happen?
Absolutely.
Really?
As a matter of fact, we have people in our office that are there just to help people when they want to come out D.C. and do tours. We'll help them line them up. And every once in a while, especially with school groups, I'll take them on. I'll actually be the tour guide.
Oh, that'd be cool.
So we have to do that in the morning before things get really busy. But I love doing that. And there's in the Capitol, statue, you got the rotunda and then the old House of Representatives that's called Statuary Hall. Every state donates two statues to be displayed. And we, in right center in Statuary Hall, is a Nebraska statue, which is William Jennings Bryan.
Okay.
And so I give a little spiel on what he why he's famous enough that Nebraska would put his statue there. You know, he ran for president 3 times. He gave the great gold cross of gold speech. He lost every time he ran for president. He was then he was the attorney for the state of Tennessee in the Scopes trial, the monkey trial, evolution. He lost that one. So I say, evidently, we give a statue to our biggest loser.
Great.
And then I tell him, I heard that the Nebraska legislature is going to swap William Jennings Bryan out with Bill Callahan.
Yeah.
That's my best laugh of the day when I tell that.
Yay! Everybody goes
People
crazy.
People like that. Yeah. It's like, yeah, we get it. He is our biggest loser.
He is our biggest loser. And every day it's a different audience. So you can tell that same joke all the time.
I call it the Ben Nelson model. Just use the same joke every time.
Different audience.
If it works.
You go to the Nebraska breakfast, you know, Nebraskans that are there just can show up on Wednesday mornings when we're in. I've heard the same joke for 3 years. Change it.
As long as people keep laughing, he ain't changing it.
Well, that's exactly right. And I've got to give him credit. He's got a couple of good lines, and they always get good laughs.
Yes, he's had a couple good ones with us. That we've talked to him a couple times. Pat did a little free association with him once.
Well,
he'd say
goodness,
something and he'd get first thing that popped in his head.
I gotta
head.
Try to find it. Let's see if we can find this.
See if you can find it in there because
that would be dangerous for some people.
Funny.
Like
it was funny. And I think one of them was, that's not it.
I don't think this is it. I don't know.
Where are they at?
But we earlier in the year, Regis and Kelly Lee had the... Regis and Kelly had had a contest to get...
I know.
I say that all the time. Had a contest to try to get radio people, idiots like me, guys, boys, to co-host when Regis was on vacation.
It was, they were looking for just like a one-day or one-week thing where they could get somebody in there and you'd win a guest slot. And so had to apply for it and then it was judged online. So this one over here puts a video together.
Well, we had just done the faces on the barroom floor with Clay Anderson and Ben Nelson was there.
Yeah.
And I said, hey, Senator Nelson, could you do a video for me that I could send to these guys to say, hey, my buddy Pat in Nebraska really needs this. He wants this job, this little co-hosting gig. So about 3 days later, I get this link for a YouTube video that he did for me. It's like, hey, you know, Pat, really, it's really good. High definition. It's like lighting.
It's funny.
It was perfect. I didn't get it, you know, so it worked really, really well.
Wow.
Yeah.
It didn't help.
I thought senators had more pull than that.
Exactly.
At least that's what they tell me.
Regis didn't care.
Me too.
was unimpressed.
Me too.
Yeah. So in any case, he did that. And so we got a chance to talk to him as well and played this word association where Pat would say something and he'd say the first thing that popped in his mind.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
All right.
Peanut butter.
Sandwich. Mm.
Sarah Palin.
Nothing.
I kind of like the
That's funny. Okay, Facebook.
I have one. I have a page.
Okay.
Ah, yep.
Hunting.
What I want to do this weekend, if I can.
There you go.
Frequent flyer miles.
I got a lot of them.
Okay, that's what I figured he would say. Okay, and the last one, Bo Pelini.
Just try to use them. Win Saturday night against A&M.
That's
please,
right.
Please.
For God's
exactly,
sakes.
Exactly, yes.
Yeah, so if I ever need anything, a big job or something, can I come to you for an endorsement? Because obviously it didn't work with Senator Nelson.
No, I think probably a House member would do a better job.
I think so too.
Yeah.
I think it's right there. It's written on the wall.
Yeah.
That's what we look. You know, they say that every day the senators get up, they look themselves, and look in the mirror and see a president.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we in the house say we look in the mirror and see a senator.
That's funny.
Is it like a family a little bit like, you know, growing up, like in the same house with a large family when you're dealing with the same people, because you know you deal with the same people.
That is a great analogy.
And so you know what makes them tick. You know how to push their buttons. You kind of play some games on each other. Are there a little practical joking going on?
Oh, there always is.
You guys and their practical jokes. Can't you just see them? Yep.
What are you looking forward to the most getting back to Washington?
Well, just getting back to the day-to-day activities, especially ways that we can, without spending bazillions of dollars, try and get our economy back on track and create jobs. Yeah. Now, we can look at stock market and everything else, but until we start creating jobs, we aren't growing our economy, and the people aren't going to believe we're growing our economy until they see people going back to work.
Mm-hmm. Perception is reality. I mean, it really is. It doesn't matter what the numbers say. The way people are living and what their reality is, I mean, for them, around them, that's the real story.
That's exactly right.
Bottom line.
So that's what we got to go to work. We got a really busy month. Some things are going to be very controversial. We got to do another continuing resolution to keep the government open. You can say that we just went through that, and we did. Five months ago, and... road transportation bill, keeping airports open. The president's new stimulus bill, whatever that's going to be.
Oh, that's true.
So there's got a lot on our table for 1 month.
Yeah.
So enjoy the rest of your vacation.
Yes.
No, really, because next week when you get back, it's
Saturday is all mine.
You're going to tear it up on Saturday. All right, we're going to take a very short break and come back. We have a segment called Top News. You have a Facebook page, Twitter, everything. You tweet. Do you tweet yourself, or do you have somebody that does
it
for you?
I occasionally tweet myself, but I've got a tweeter.
You got a tweeter?
That's a good idea. Pat needs one.
I know, because I don't tweet enough.
But I can tweet right now on my cell phone, but I just choose not to.
Okay.
Funny. Yeah.
So we have a segment called Top News. It's from our Facebook page. So we're going to come back and do that real quick with Representative Lee Terry, and then and get some of your phone calls too. Emails Pat and JT at Q985FM.com. Top News.
Time for another edition of Pat and JT's Facebook Top News.
We'll start highbrow. Tommy says, is going to attempt to do the Kessel Run in under 12 parsecs today. Anybody?
I don't know what that means.
12 parsecs? Oh, come on. Star Wars. Hello.
Do you know
Millennium Falcon was the only ship. It was the only ship to make the Kessel Run in under 12 parsecs.
I don't even know what that means.
What?
Okay, the Kessel.
Does anyone in this room know what that meant?
Someone did.
Oh.
Lee Terry's handler.
Yeah. He's the boss of the district office. I forgot to ask the nerdy Star Wars questions in the interview.
Brienne, only 3 sleeps till the Scurs.
3 sleeps.
Go Oscars.
That's right.
Sydney, don't you love when people post all their drama on Facebook for everyone to read? I find it very entertaining.
We wouldn't have Top News if they didn't.
Thank God. Carolyn, Tanya, considering Skillet is opening for Daughtry on Sunday, and we are VIPs and we'll be close enough to touch all of them, won't that count as for going to church? As I'm anticipating a religious experience through their music, and it is Sunday after all.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Skillet's got roots in the Christian community, too, so they're like a break.
That's right. Yesterday when we were looking for Skid Row, I typed in Skid Row, and we had Skid Row, and Skillet was right underneath
Skillet.
It. The opposite of Skid Row.
Exactly. April, 2 miles on Red Oak Track before 6 a.m., done. Larry goes, nothing more refreshing than an early morning drive.
No kidding. That's the only way it happened for me.
Jamie, so glad I didn't start buying wedding expletive. Thank God I censored myself. She goes on because someone says, oh no, hon, what happened? She goes, long story short, his decision, but you got to remember, it's all my fault, lol.
Oh, a little bitter too.
Nice.
Beth, doesn't take much to excite me. All excited over the new Husker flag I bought for the front of my house. Can't wait to put it out.
Good.
From Failbook, Tom says, you know what I love most about collage girls? Sammy, you can fit so many on the same page. I think you meant college girls.
Collage.
Collage.
I notice when we have a member of Congress in studio, you're quick, you're tight, you're not screwing up, you're doing a great job.
I wore pants today.
I know, but I mean, it's like it's flowing.
Is that unusual for you?
I wear swim trunks a lot. I'm very liberal with the dress policy.
I don't even care about the dress policy. It's a struggle most mornings. But today, apparently, he showed up.
Yeah. What can I say? I'm looking to go be an intern, dude.
He's got it.
I'm jumping ship.
If a guy like this rolled into your office wanting an internship, what would you guys say?
What's up?
Well, yeah, he fit right in, actually.
Yes.
Yeah, I was going to say, you look like most of our interns right now.
Thank
so.
God. See? And all you guys give me crap all the time about it.
That's funny.
Official seal right there. Danny is unofficially 24 today. So is Chris and Amber, Kelly, Jenny, Samantha, Tanya, and Lisa. Carolyn is 14 today. Christian is 34. Erica is 28. Alton is 67. And we had a write-in from Jennifer. Jennifer's busting her dad out today. Her dad, Gene, is officially 56, but she does say that he would probably rather be unofficially 24. But you messed up, Jen. You told me he was 56,
sorry.
So we're calling it.
Happy birthday, Gene.
Now for the totally legit friend out of the day.
Why can't we be friends?
You may have heard of him. He might be your friend, Lee. His name is Uncle Sam. Uncle Sam.
Not spam at all.
And our uncle wants us to know that we want glue.
Yay!
Facebook and Nelson confirmed.